So this video, it shows you about the both TIG welding and MIG welding. The major difference between the TIG welding and the MIG welding is usage of the electrode. So in TIG welding, it uses of a non-consumable electrode. So there is an additional filler material with that. Whereas in a MIG welding, there is a consumable electrode. So there is no need of a additional filler material. But this apparatus, the arrangement is similar for both the welding types. So there is an inert gas cylinder and a power source. There is also a coolant system. So there is an electrode holder. So one end of the power source is connected to the workpiece, the other end is connected to the electrode holder. So since the TIG welding, it makes use of a non-consumable electrode and additional filler material. So this is a filler rod along with that the electrode, non-consumable electrode. So additional filler rod is used because it uses a non-consumable electrode, and when it is moved against, an arc is set between the electrode and the workpiece. So this is how a tungsten inert gas welding takes place. And the next video, it's about metal inert gas welding. So this is how the tungsten inert gas welding is made. And the next one is about metal inert gas welding. So here we know that the electrode is fed as a wire. So there is an arrangement attached with the power source to feed the electrode. So there wire is bound in this, the electrode wire is bound in this roller, and it is fed inside the electrode holder along with the two rollers. So the rollers, when it is rotating on the opposite direction, it feeds the electrode. So this arrangement is something similar to a pen, where the inert gas is also fed in order to prevent the oxidation. So here there is no additional filler material used, since it is a metal inert gas welding. It uses of only the consumable electrode. So the consumable electrode, it itself acts as a filler material and creates a joint between the two work pieces, which is surrounded by inert gas. So this is about the working of tungsten and metal inert gas welding. So the next one is about gas welding. So this arrangement, it shows how a gas welding is done. So these are the equipments that are used for doing a gas welding. There is a gas cylinder in which one it contains oxygen, the other it contains an acetylene or hydrogen. So two type of gas weldings are done. One is oxyacetylene gas welding, the other one is oxyhydrogen gas welding. So in this our syllabus, we will be seeing about oxyacetylene gas welding. So first we can see what is gas welding. So metals, it can be joined in many different ways. Gas welding is one of the most important because of its scope of application. Gas welding is one of the oldest form of heat based welding and remains go to option for many industries. So most of the industries, they are opting this type of gas welding other than that of tungsten and metal gas welding. So the reason why this welding technique has a great fanfare is because of its ease of use and a low cost nature. Carrying out a welding process with a gas welding is relatively easy compared to that of other arc weldings. So when a fuel such as acetylene is used, a flame can be reached up to a temperature of 3100 degrees Celsius. This temperature is lower than what we get from arc welding, but it gives a better performance than that of the arc welding. So the gas welding, it requires two gases. One is oxygen and the other one will be the fuel gas. So the fuel gas, it can be an acetylene or a hydrogen, which are safely mixed together as oxyacetylene and oxyhydrogen, and it requires a mechanism for the welder to control the flames. So the equipment that are used for a gas welding are a fuel cylinder. So there will be a fuel cylinder and an oxygen cylinder, which are combined and merged in at a single point, and a control valve. So both gases have their control valves. So when it reaches a higher pressure, it can be controlled. And mixer chamber. So mixer chamber is for the both the oxygen and the fuel gas to get mixed up. And a welding torch. A welding torch contains the mixture chamber and a control valve. At the other end of the torch is a nozzle where fuel oxygen mixture is burnt together. So these are some of the equipment that are needed for an gas welding. So the characteristics of oxyacetylene welding, it includes the usage dual oxygen and acetylene stored under pressure in steel cylinders. It has its ability to switch quickly to a cutting process by changing the welding tip to a cutting tip. The high temperature of the gas mixture attains the use of regulators to control gas flow, and it reduces the pressure on both oxygen tank and the acetylene tank. The use of double liner rubber hoses to conduct the gas from the tank to the torch. Melting the materials to be welded together. The ability to regulate the temperature by adjusting gas flow. So this is an arrangement of a oxyacetylene welding. Here is a workpiece material along with which is a filler rod, and there is a torch in which the both the oxygen and acetylene gets mixed up in the mixing chamber. So these are some of the types of flame that are possible in an oxyacetylene welding. So there are three types of flames. One is carburizing flame, neutral flame, and an oxidizing flame. So first we can look into what is carburizing flame. So it is a carburizing flame is when there is a excess of oxygen. Oxidizing flame when there is excess of oxygen, the neutral flame when there is oxygen and acetylene mixed in equal proportions, and carburizing flame when acetylene is more in proportion than that of oxygen. So these are the three types of flames that occurs in during the gas welding process. So this is about the gas welding oxyacetylene process. Thank you.